First of all, I congratulate you and welcome you on behalf of the entire team of Lex Templum. Congratulations for securing All India Rank 2 and cracking a seat in PSU. So first of all, tell me, how do you feel after securing such a good rank in one of the toughest exams of India?
Thank you so much. And it's a great feeling for securing All India Rank 2. And most of all, the entire point of securing this rank was to be inducted in a PSU, and that is also done. So the feeling which could not be expressed in words, it is such a great feeling.
Okay. Priyanshi, can you elaborate a little bit about your selection in your PSU by securing this good rank, like All India Rank 2? How did you get through it and where are you currently working? Can you give an elaborative statement on the same?
Yes. So, for securing, for being inducted in any PSU, one should at least secure in top 10 if for a short selection. So this was my point in securing All India Rank 2. And being securing a rank, you should prepare for the interview as well for the PSU sector, because that also plays an important part and it has a weightage. And then there are certain other formalities. So major weightage is of 85% of CLAT, and then the 15% and 20% weightage is of interview.
Okay, great. Priyanshi, can you elaborately explain what strategy did you adopt while cracking the exam, preparing for the exam basically, your strategy?
So till December 2020, I focused on the constitution and the basic subject, constitution, criminal law, contracts, PPA. So these were the basic subjects that I focused on. And from January onwards, I started my essay writing. I started seeing the current affairs, which were there, legal news. And for that, I took help of Live Law, SEC online blog. Then I also took help of Gautam Bhatia. Then Faizan Mustafa sir's YouTube video. That is of great help. So, and my strategy has been that till December, I had made a calendar. I had made my monthly targets, then the weekly targets, and then the daily targets. Like, for example, for 2 months, I dedicated to constitution because it plays a major role. Then for criminal law, IPC, I took 1 month. Then for CRPC, I took 20 days. So these were the targets that I prepared for myself. And then I stuck to it, that it cannot be extended. Anyhow, I had to complete those within that deadline. And then I made a weekly target, and then I made a daily target of 8 to 10 hours. Then talking about the current legal portion. So till December, what I used to do was, I was going through Live Law mainly, and whatever the important facts and the important judgments were there. So I used to copy paste them and save it in the Word document. And then on Sunday, I would go through the entire document, whatever I had done for the week. And from January onwards, I made it the point to revise them as well. So my legal current affairs started from January onwards, and till December, I made my basic subjects clear.
So you would agree on the point that one should prepare for the fundamental knowledge of the subject as well as the contemporary cases, right?
Yes. So when we go through the past CLAT paper of 2020, I took note of the 3 points that that made me prepare for CLAT 2021. First one, that any para that came, it focused on the CLAT current judgment. Then it would ask for the landmark judgment, which would be in the past. And then the basics, the barracks, the sections, the articles. So one should, while preparing, one should see the 3 main sources. First of all is the current, second is the landmark judgment, and the third is the barrack.
Okay. Priyanshi, due to COVID prevailing situations in the country, the paper became actually very unpredictable. First, it was essay writing and then MCQs, and then suddenly a change came. So, how did you cope up with the change as a student while preparing for the same?
Yes, it was really a tough scenario, and COVID second wave was a really tough one. So, for that, till April, I had prepared for essay writing from January onwards till April. After April, there was some mental stress as well. So, like if I was preparing for twice a day for essay, or then weekly I was preparing for thrice, then I would do after in May, I cut short my essay writing because somewhere at the back of the mind it was there that they will cut short the essay. Somewhere because of the panic and because of the loss we were going through that time. I had also mailed several mails to the consortium as well. And but hard work was there, and I had the point that I have to clear this at first attempt as well only. So I did not cut short my hard work. I gave my 8 to 10 hours a day, and that's how.
Okay, Priyanshi, can you please tell us how our material, Lex Templum's material, helped you in paving your way and securing this rank in CLAT?
So it was in March that I joined this Lex Templum mock series. And I'm really grateful for this because Lex Templum series help you streamline the preparation part. When you join the mock, then you get to know that whether you are preparing the right way or whether you are just studying everything and anything. Okay. Which to some extent I was doing till March. I was preparing, but it was not streamlined. Maybe I had not studied that Jadhav case. I had not studied that a privacy case. So there were some cases that I had not studied, which through the mocks I got to know. And even if I had studied privacy, so there were Aadhaar judgment somewhere I had missed it. So mock series helped me to streamline my process.
Okay, great. Priyanshi, can you briefly explain that how do you traveled being a law graduate to, you know, end up in a PSU, which is almost every student's dream, to end up and have a good government job in the PSU sector? So can you explain your journey?
When I joined the law school, I have studied from Dr. Ram Manohar Lohia National Law University. So in the first year, in second year, in third year, I had no idea about PSU. I was studying mainly for just to make my basics clear, and mainly for judicial preparation as well. Somewhere at the back of the mind, I had it. Then the fourth year, I came in contact with the last year topper, Komadi Umrao. She's the topper of CLAT 2020. So she was preparing for CLAT 2020. And when she secured All India Rank 1, so I contacted her. I asked her to give her guidance. And it was in fifth year that I made up a mind of going in the PSU sector. Before that, it was only that I was making my basics clear. I was doing internships. I had that in the mind that private placement would also be, private placements. But then in fifth year, when I saw the working of a PSU sector, I saw her joining there. I saw the work culture. So it was like, it was such an esteemed job that I wanted to do it. I wanted to crack it in the first time. So in the fifth year, I gave my 100% to join that sector.
Great. Okay, Priyanshi, can you can you explain our upcoming upcoming students who will be writing this examination in the near future as to what, in percentage or in certain brief way, can you explain what importance did you give to cases and the conceptual part of law while preparing for CLAT? And also, please provide some tips as to the point of time management. Because if you compare 2020 and 2021 paper, time management was one of the very important factor while cracking the exam, because suddenly the number of passages were increased. So how did you manage all these, and what importance did you give, whether it was to a case law or to a conceptual concept?
Okay. So coming to the preparation part, first I would like to say that you should have your basics clear. whether it be constitution, it be contracts, it be TP or criminal law. The basic subject, no doubt, the CLAT has 13 to 14 number of subjects that you need to prepare. But when we talk about the basic subjects, family law, PPA, contracts, criminal law, and constitution, you should have the basics clear, and basics means direct should be learned by heart.
Correct.
Then they- This is what I focused first point. Then secondly, talking about the current affairs, I think since January is coming, and one should start preparing for the cases as well, because cases, it's like 50-50%. You should know about the basics as well, and you should be thorough about the current affairs and the landmark judgments. So from January onwards, start preparing for the current cases and the landmark cases which have been there at least for the past 3 years.
Correct.
So this has been their strategy. And then talking about the international law, talking about the environment law, these are the subjects which we cannot cover the entire in the entirety. So we need to focus on the judgments. The first, like environment impact assessment that had been done in the past 2 years, I think in 2019 or 2020. So one should see to that. And then the Justice Chandrachud's judgment, there has been one environment judgment. So apart from the basic subjects, these international law, environment law, or income tax one, we should focus on the judgment main. And through the judgment, we should go on the sections. The sections that has been mentioned in the judgment, we should study those. So reverse study would go for these subjects.
Correct.
From the judgment to the sections.
Good. Okay, and the time management part, how did you manage that?
Time management, I had I was keeping a note for the time management, and I would want to make this clear whether descriptive part is coming in 2022.
No clarity as such till date, as it was last year, but yes, it may come. Probability is still prevalent.
So from January onwards, I had started preparing for essay, and 30 minutes I would give for one essay. Like there was this concept that 25 marks would be there. And so 1 hour for two essays. Essays, hello?
Yeah, you're audible.
Okay. So I would give 1 hour for two essay writing, and talking about the passage time part. I would solve the mocks on a regular basis. Mock plays an important role when it comes to time management.
And that was my next question, that how did mock help you in time management well apart? Yes.
So if there are 10 passages for 100 marks, if we divide the paper in 150, seeing the 25-25 essay part and 100 marks for objective type. So there would be, if we see, there would be 10 passages for 100 marks, but this has not been followed in 2021 and there were many passages. But the way I prepared was that 100 marks, I should give at least a minimum to 60 to 80 minutes for 100 marks, for 10 passages. So mocks plays an important role because you need to see how could you manage your time. There are passages which could take more time as would have been, like you would have thought of giving 10 minutes, but you are giving 15 minutes for that passage. So ultimately, if by chance and like you are giving 15 minutes for one passage, then for the next passage you have to complete it in within 5 minutes. So it's all about the mock and the practices that you can do, mock practices, till the time you attempt the paper. At least 10 to 12 mocks you should give
before the D-Day, right? The final day of the exam.
Yes.
Okay. Priyanshi, can you give some tips and share your experience of cracking PSU interview all apart, basically? How did you do that? How did you prepare it?
So, this was completely new for me because I had not sit for any private placement in the college paper. I had completely made up my mind for PSU. So I contacted certain people who are working there and I asked them about the interview part. You just need to be chill there, because you have already started enough while preparing for client. And if you have secured a good rank, that means you have enough knowledge. Then secondly, you need to prepare on your personality part. How to get what interviewer is asking. You should be able to know about it. You should be able to interpret the question and give the answers in brief. At 30 to 40 seconds, you should be able to answer a question. Interviewers do not need long answers. This is the major part. Then for the interview, there are certain subjects that you need to prepare, such as arbitration, IBC, which we also prepare for CLAT. But in this section, should know the practical part as well. Too little. And you should know the cases, important cases which are coming in this IBC arbitration, because most of the PSUs are dealing in these cases only, like these subjects, which is involving arbitration, IBC. These are the major subjects. Then labor laws are there, which you should be well-versed while giving the interview. And there's also a portion of group discussion while giving PSU interview. So in that as well, like in my PSU interview, Power Grid, we were asked to give to be a part of group discussion, to take part in that. And then we were asked to write in on a paper whatever we have discussed and any other view on that particular topic. So the panel wanted to know about our writing skill as well. How could we manage our thoughts? And we were given 5 minutes to write everything. So one should know about, one should be able to frame all her or his ideas within that 5 minutes in a paper. That was it. It's easy. Like if you are prepared well for the CLAT, then you could easily able to crack a PSU interview. Just focus on your personality and focus on certain subjects which could be asked more in a PSU interview.
Okay. Thank you so much, Priyanshi, for taking out time from your busy schedule, coming here, sharing your tips, techniques with all the upcoming aspirants. I once again congratulate you for securing such an amazing rank in one of the most toughest examinations these days. So congratulations once again, and thank you so much.
Thank you.